Good morning. This is Jaqueline Mutere from Grace Agenda in Kenya, an organization that supports survivors of rape from the post-election violence of 2007-2008, and mainly those that had children from the rapes. Following the disputed elections, of course, there's a lot of violence and also there are a lot of rapes, but it's only about a year or so later that it was discovered that there was a great number of children that had been born from the rapes. I am a survivor of the same, and mine was it happened in January of that year, and then by February that I knew I had conceived. So throughout that period, I attempted to have 3 abortions, but I was unable to do so. And that's also because the laws in Kenya don't allow for abortion. And secondly, I would have had them had the abortion done in a quack doctor's place, and on one of the times when I had actually gone for a consultation, it didn't work because there was a crackdown on those on that institution, and it was locked down. So following that, of course, I had the baby. I'm grateful that I have her. Her name is Princess. She's now 7 years old. But thereafter, I had a lot of health complications. Of course, that also comes due to the trauma. I was mentally stressed out. I had a very serious health issue. There's an impact also on my status and generally on the implication also on my family. I am a widow, so I had just had a baby previous year. So having yet another baby had serious implications. It had an implication on my finances, that I'd have another mouth to feed and I'd have other children to take care of, and also on my mental stability, because now this would mean, of course, because having another baby, that first of all impacted my own body, and then secondly about my finances, and now mentally how I was going to be able to manage my entire family. So this is the life of an average woman, the average survivor. And generally speaking, I'm an empowered woman, and at least I had options. But with the women that I have dealt with, they live under very strenuous circumstances. Many of them are HIV infected. Many of them actually had the babies, so those who were unable to procure abortions. There are some who attempted abortions and have children with disabilities. Some of them were women with disabilities who got pregnant, tried to have abortions, but it impacted their health negatively because they went to quack institutions. So all this has got a long-term impact. First of all, because you're constantly going to the hospital to get medical help for the infections that you've acquired, either from the abortions or from your status. Then there is also the social impact, which deals with the children, because here you are, you have had a child that you really did not want, and therefore you are abusing this child. So this child ends up very abused, very neglected. There are women who have abandoned their children, there are women who have killed their children simply because of what it portended on their families and their family needs. And many of them are also single women who have to bring up their families and the children alone. So this is very negative, and I don't think this should be the case. So for access to comprehensive healthcare should be a priority for governments, and especially ours in Kenya. Firstly, because you will be able to get the psychosocial support, you'll be able to get the proper counseling and the medical attention that you do need. That is available, but not on a long-term focus. Then you should be able to get, if you are a person with a disability or a woman with a disability, access to either physiotherapy or support for the disability in which you suffer from. Because I do have 2 people in the program who have got intellectual disabilities, and basically their guardians really struggle to actually manage them with the children, and even during the entire time of pregnancy, because abortion for them was not an option. Thirdly, you'd also need a comprehensive healthcare for you physically, medically, and on what it is that you would need to take care of yourself long term. But ultimately, the most important thing is having the availability of comprehensive services, and especially abortion as an option, so that you take care of yourself and so that you are mentally secure. You're a mentally complete person, and that you're managing the added burden to your family. That you've got options, that you're able to have a valuable life, so that you can able to take care of your children, take care of yourself also, and take care of your and ultimately take care of your communities, and actually managing your post-rape trauma effectively. It really would be a positive thing if we would have access to abortion services for survivors of rape. Thank you.